valves and in patients who had previous history of infective endocarditis. Cardiac transplant patients should definitely have a infective endocarditis prophylaxis, especially even if they don't have any valvular heart disease, any leak for the first 6 months, because there is significant endothelial disruption after all those sutures. But patients who had a mild, who have a mild to moderate valve regurgitation, especially if they have a mild or moderate TR or MR, they should definitely have an infective endocarditis prophylaxis if they go for some of the procedures. Unrepaired congenital cyanotic heart disease should have an infective endocarditis prophylaxis, but even if they've had a completed repair, but with the prosthetic material, like a Dacron graft or something, they need to have an infective endocarditis prophylaxis. Repaired defects with residual shunts should definitely have a prophylaxis because they have a jet inside the heart there. Now what's, and dental procedures are the highest, have the highest incidence of bacteremia, and whenever there's a dental procedure with manipulation of gingival tissue or manipulation of periapical region, or if there's a perforation of oral mucosa, they need to have